morning, and we'll start this morning by remaining seated and singing Jesus, You Are Changing Me. Rather than from the end of December. So it's the first day of the church's year for the coming year. One notice, next Sunday, which is Gift Sunday, which you already know, was scheduled to have a members' meeting after the service. That meeting is going to be postponed until the new year. So there won't be a members' meeting after the service next Sunday morning. And now, as is our tradition through Advent, we're going to have the candles lit and some introductory prayers. Thank you.
Today is the first Sunday of Advent. Advent means coming. And in this season, we prepare for the coming of Christ. One of the ways we prepare for his coming is by making an Advent wreath and lighting its candles to remind us of the gifts Christ brings to the world. The Advent wreath includes many symbols to help us think about Christ and his gifts. The wreath itself is in the shape of a circle. A circle has no beginning and no end. This reminds us that there is no beginning and no end to God, and that God's love and caring are forever.
The light from the candles, which grows stronger each Sunday in Advent, reminds us that Jesus is the light of the world. Today we light the candle of hope. The people of Israel hoped in God's promises and were not disappointed. Again and again, God delivered Israel from its enemies. We too have the same experience of salvation. That is why we believe in God's promise to send Jesus to us once again to judge the world and establish his kingdom forever upon the earth.
Thank you.
Hope is like a light shining in a dark place. As we look at the light of this candle, we celebrate the hope we have in Jesus Christ. Let us pray. Thank you, God, for the hope you give us. We ask that as we wait for all your promises to come true and for Christ to come again, that you would remain present with us. Help us today and every day to worship you, to hear your word, and to do your will by sharing your hope with each other. We ask it in the name of the one who was born in Bethlehem. Amen.
Thank you. The Gospel reading is from Mark chapter 13, verses 24 to 37. At that time, after the anguish of those days, the sun will be darkened, the moon will give no light, the stars will fall from the sky, and the powers in the heavens will be shaken. Then everyone will see the Son of Man coming on the clouds with great power and glory. And he will send out his angels to gather his chosen ones from all over the world, from the farthest ends of the earth and heaven. Now learn a lesson from the fig tree. When its branches bud and its leaves begin to sprout, you know that summer is near. In the same way, when you see all these things taking place, you can know that his return is very near, right at the door. I tell you the truth, this generation will not pass from the scene before all these things take place. Heaven and earth will disappear, but my words will never disappear. However, no one knows the day or the hour when these things will happen. Not even the angels in heaven or the Son himself. Only the Father knows. And since you don't know when that time will come, be on guard. Stay alert. The coming of the Son of Man can be illustrated by the story of a man going on a long trip. When he left home, he gave each of his slaves instructions about the work they were to do, and he told the gatekeeper to watch for his return. You too must keep watch, for you don't know when the master of the household will return, in the evening, at midnight, before dawn, or at daybreak. Don't let him find you sleeping when he arrives without warning. I say to you what I say to everyone. Watch for him. This is the word of the Lord.
Pieces of paper turned over. Kate's going to come and share a rather lovely prayer with us. Thank you.
This is the prayer of God of Waiting from Christian Aid. God of the waiting, give us courage to wait with those in the most broken places of the world, and with all those who struggle to be bearers of hope there. We pray for those who wait for wars to stop, for violence to cease. God of the waiting, turn conflict into peace. And we pray for those who give up on the coming of hope because they feel they wait in vain at checkpoints, at borders, for jobs, for food, and for all those whose lives are crushed under the structures and systems of injustice. God of the waiting, wait with your world. Turn anger into reconciliation, and our lack of hope into courage, so that our waiting may be over, and all the things of darkness shall be no more.
And our next hymn, worship song, is going to be on video with the words, so we remain seated and please do join in if you know it.
Save our sons and daughters. Refugee by Malcolm Geat. We think of him as safe beneath the steeple, or cozy in a crib beside the font. But he is with a million displaced people on the long road of weariness and want. For even as we sing our final carol, his family is up and on that road, fleeing the wrath of someone else's quarrel, glancing behind and shouldering their load. Whilst Herod rages still from his dark tower, Christ clings to Mary, fingers tightly curled. The lambs are slaughtered by the men of power, and death squads spread their curse across the world. But every Herod dies and comes alone to stand before the Lamb upon the throne.
Now, just for us to sit and think our own thoughts and make our own prayers.
Thank you.
Very, very famous Advent hymn, "Lo, He Comes with Clouds Descending."
Oh,
moustaches. The prophet Isaiah wrote, "Here is my herald whom I send, and he will prepare your way. Prepare the way. Prepare the heart and mind. Let everyone stand silent. Let the stars and moon cease to move. Let the leaves of the trees and the tall browning grass cease to rustle in the wind. With expectant hush and long-awaiting yearning, we herald the coming of the long-awaited Christ child, the coming of the infant to Bethlehem." Thank you, Mike.
Isaiah 11. A shoot shall come out from the stock of Jesse, and a branch shall grow out of his roots. The Spirit of the Lord shall rest on him, the Spirit of wisdom and understanding, the Spirit of counsel and might, the Spirit of knowledge and the fear of the Lord. His delight shall be in the fear of the Lord. He shall not judge by what his eyes see, or decide by what his ears hear. But with righteousness he shall judge the poor, and decide with equity for the meek of the earth. He shall strike the earth with the rod of his mouth, and with the breath of his lips he shall kill the wicked. Righteousness shall be the belt around his waist, and faithfulness the belt around his loins. The wolf shall live with the lamb, the leopard shall lie down with the kid, the calf and the lion, and the fatling together, and a little child shall lead them. The cow and the bear shall graze, their young shall lie down together, and the lion shall eat straw like the ox. The nursing child shall play over the hole of the asp, and the weaned child shall put its hand on the adder's den. They will not hurt or destroy on all my holy mountain, for the earth will be full of the knowledge of the Lord as the waters cover the sea."
Whilst some of us were fortunate enough to have those memories. And it probably wasn't about there being huge numbers of presents. Quite probably, to be honest, just a sock with an orange and some nuts or something in it. And maybe one or two presents under the tree. This week's news about the drowned refugees trying to come to the UK made me start again to think about hope. Alongside that desperation lies hope. Recently, there was a man called Constantine from Romania who was homeless, and he sat by the walkway to Waitrose. I chatted with him on several days, and Beth and I gave him food a few times. Those who walked by and tutted whilst waving him off as if he were a nuisance mosquito maybe need to look at their lives in a bigger picture. I would bet that none of us has got to here without times that were incredibly tough, when hope was hard to find or acknowledge. This is a man with skills and things to offer, stuck in a system that means he can't progress, but still lives in hope. And it's lovely, on another tack, to see our local Syrian family settling in and interacting with our community whilst learning the language at a speed that I find hard to believe. Hope is what sustains us in so many situations. If this last 2 years has taught us anything, I really hope from the bottom of my heart that hope is at the centre. The media on so many occasions would have had us believe that we were lost to an invisible enemy. And yet, here we are, still believing, still a community, and still hope-filled. There's an apparently new threat. And within our community of Cowbridge, we've lost a lovely man to this virus this last week. But we still pray together, don't we? And we still hold fast to our faith, and yes, to hope too. I really do hope, in capital letters, that this Advent we can all put hope and faith at the centre of our lives. And if each one of us can encourage even one other person to think and act in a similar way, I believe that would be a real blessing. Jesus is the hope of the world, the light of the world, and we trust in his coming. And now we've got another piece on video, which I found incredibly moving, and I hope you will too.
Take me back to 8 years old, the little church on a dead end road, with a candle flicker in one hand and Dad's hand in the other. Take me back to silent night, my heart was full and the world was right, 'cause right now the world looks nothing like those innocent Decembers. These days peace on earth is hard to find, and I need you to remind me one more time. You're still the hope of Christmas. You're still the light when the world looks dark. You're still the hope of Christmas. And you're still the hope of my heart. Falling down like a blanket on this town. For a moment we can hardly see the pain this year has brought us. May the sick find healing's touch, may hatred's fight be one with love, and may every heart make room for you, the one who came to save us. 'Cause you're still the hope. Took me back to 8 years old, my daddy's hand and a story told about heaven's love and the manger low, and a promise that's still true. You're still the hope of Christmas. You're still the light when the world looks dark. You're still the hope of Christmas. and you're still the hope of my heart.
Like that as much as I did. You're ready, I don't need to say a word, thank you.
Let us pray. The response to the prayers is, Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Heavenly Father, as once again we prepare for Christmas, help us to find time in our busy lives for quiet and thought and prayer, that we may reflect upon the wonder of your love and allow the story of the Saviour's birth to penetrate our hearts and minds. So may our joy be deeper, our worship more real, and our lives worthier of all that you have done for us through the coming of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. We pray for peace. Give peace to the world. We thank especially at this time of the people of the Syria, the Holy Lands, the Yemen. We think also of the people of Afghanistan and all the places in the world where people live constantly on the edge of conflict. Give peace to the victims of war, the refugees, all those who have lost loved ones. Give peace to family and friends, to those who have quarrelled and need to be reconciled. Give peace in our own divided hearts. We know that without justice there can be no peace. Let peace come when all people are respected, regardless of race and religion. Let peace come when trading weapons of mass destruction is a crime. Let peace come when the earth's resources are used wisely for the common good. Let peace come when money is used to serve and not enslave the world. Let peace come through the transformation of our lives, that we may do justice, love and kindness, and walk humbly with our God. Your Son came as the Prince of Peace and brought a message of peace for all people. Help us be peacemakers in our own homes, at our work or wherever we meet people, so that the peace and goodwill of Christmas can find a place in the hearts of all people. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for our leaders. Give strength and wisdom to European and world leaders in their efforts to solve the problems of indebted governments and the threat of war and terrorist activity. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray for people in need. We pray for homeless people and for refugees who have no country to call their own. Let your blessing be with those who work to help the homeless this Christmas, and give to all of us the determination to help where we can. We pray especially for Christian organisations who help the homeless and refugees, the Salvation Army, Crisis, Oasis, Coffee for Craig and others. We pray for those who cannot find useful work, who are unemployed, who have been made redundant. We pray for people who are lonely, those who are lonely because they have lost a partner, those who are lonely because no one seems to care, those who are lonely because of handicap or illness. Let your presence be with those who are alone at this season of friendship, and may we take your friendship to those whom we know will be alone this Christmas. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for those who are ill. We pray for friends and family who are ill at this time, and remember them in the quietness of our hearts. We bring them to you in the confidence that you love them and know their every need, and that your healing power is still the same today. Bless that all that is being done for their recovery, and answer our prayers as you see best. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray for the church, for the Christian family who will be celebrating this festival in so many different ways, and for those who dare not celebrate openly. For Christians in countries where there is persecution, for Christians in our own country with whom we will share our celebrations. For our church families, grant that all who come into our churches this Christmas time may be enabled to renew their relationship with you. Help us all to be glad of your presence and to rejoice at the coming of Jesus. May your blessing be upon all who worship with us. Give us grace to live as faithful members of your family, that we may learn each day afresh to love and serve you. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Jesus Christ is the light of the world, a light which no darkness can quench. We hold before God friends and family who have died, and light a candle to symbolise the light of Christ, which eternally shines and brings hope. I leave a silence for you to put in the name of anyone you wish to pray for at this time. Help us to experience the comfort of the Holy Spirit within us and the fellowship of the church family around us. You turn our darkness into light. In your light shall we see light. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ, in whose name we offer our prayer. We'll now say the Lord's Prayer together. Our Father,
who art in heaven, I'm going to read the poem Advent 1955 by John Betjeman. The Advent wind begins to stir with sea-like sounds in our Scotch fir. It's dark at breakfast, dark at tea, and in between we only see clouds hurrying across the sky and rain-wet roads the wind blows dry and branches bending to the gale against great skies all silver pale. The world seems travelling into space, and travelling at a faster pace than in the leisured summer weather, when we in it sit out together. For now we feel the world spin round, on some momentous journey bound. Journey to what? To whom? To where? The Advent bells call out, prepare! Your world is journeying to the birth of God made man for us on earth. And how, in fact, do we prepare the great day that awaits us there? For the 25th day of December, the birth of Christ. For some it means an interchange of hunting seams on coloured cards. And I remember last year I sent out 20 yards, laid end to end of Christmas cards, to people that I scarcely know. They'd send a card to me, and so I had to send one back. Oh dear, is this a form of Christmas cheer? Or is it, which is less surprising, my pride gone in for advertising? The only cards that really count are that extremely small amount from real friends who keep in touch and are not rich but love us much. Some ways indeed are very odd, by which we hail the birth of God. We raise the price of things in shops, we give plain boxes fancy tops, and lines which traders cannot sell, thus parcels go extremely well. We dole out bribes we call a present to those to whom we must be pleasant for business reasons. Our defence is these bribes are charged against expenses and bring relief in income tax. Enough of these unworthy cracks. The time draws near the birth of Christ, a present that cannot be priced, given 2,000 years ago. Yet if God had not given so, he still would be a distant stranger and not a baby in the manger.
Thank you. And so our final hymn is in fact a Christmas carol, and I make no apology because it's probably my absolute favourite, and I can never wait to get to Advent Sunday for us to be able to sing In the Bleak Midwinter. loving God, as we end our time together and leave this place, let us go in hope, live by hope, and be signs of hope for all to see in Jesus' name. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among us and remain with us always. Amen.
Amen.